We're going to start with build mode, and in build mode I'm going to start from scratch in ProcessBook. I have the ProcessBook application open with no workbook or display file open at this time. We just have the application running. Now in ProcessBook, when you create something, you have one of two choices if you're starting from step one. You can either create a ProcessBook workbook file and then populate it with entries. These are sometimes referred to as displays, and they can be other items as well. Or you can create individual display files which have a .pdi extension, and those are simply kept in a folder somewhere on your file system. Now ProcessBook doesn't really care which one you use. The benefits or disadvantages are all contained from an organizational or housekeeping point of view. If you are in the habit of sharing your displays with other people, it could very well be more convenient for you to keep your display files as independent pages in a folder somewhere, and that way you don't have to share your entire workbook. However, if you don't share things or you don't use your displays with things like web clients, then it might be advantageous for you to keep them all in one place, and in that case a workbook may work very well for you. So it really depends on the organization and how you want to set up your display files. One note, just like any other Windows application, if there's an asterisk next to the name of the file, it simply means there have been changes that have not been saved since the file was opened. We're going to look at the ProcessBook workbook since it's the more complex of the two structures. I've got ProcessBook open with no structures available. It's just the application running with no displays or workbooks open. And I want to create a new workbook for myself. So I'll select File and New. And at this point, the new dialog box opens and the default is ProcessBook entry. However, I don't have a workbook to create entries within, so I'm going to select the ProcessBook PIW file, and I'm going to call this CBT Demo Workbook, and I'll click OK. And what we get is a blank ProcessBook workbook. There's no, even though it looks like there's a page here, there's nothing really here yet. It's just an empty container. And so what I want to do is create a simple entry on this workbook that's going to be the heading for my first page. Again, I'll select File and New. This time I'll select ProcessBook Entry and click OK. And I want a type of entry called Text. Now I'm going to call this Page 1 for my label and click OK. And what you see is that I have a text entry. The text entries are denoted with no icon next to them. And because it's a level 1, I get Page 1. Now at this point you can add entries to this page or create additional pages or add whatever you wish to this workbook. I am simply going to save my workbook to my desktop. Once I get my workbook established, I need to add things to it. The most common entry you're going to add to a workbook is a display file. The display file is what you're going to be using most of the time. In this case, I'm going to select File and New. And this is where you have to be very, very careful. Most people assume because they want a display entry in this workbook that they should select ProcessBook display file. This is the wrong thing to select. Very often people will create displays using this method and then go into their workbook and realize there's nothing in it. Because by selecting this third item down, ProcessBook display file, you are in fact creating a standalone display file, not a display within this workbook. To create a display within the workbook, leave the selection ProcessBook entry checked and click OK. At this point you're going to want to make sure display is checked, which it is, and you're going to want to give your display a label. I'm going to call this Demo Display 1. And I'm going to click on Level to make it a Level 2 and click OK. And you can see I've got my display there. Now, I will save my changes. If you want to edit this, let's say I didn't want to call this Demo Display 1, I wanted to call it just Display 1. I can simply go into build mode and double click on it, and it will give me the dialog box that appears there as well. I can change whatever I wish at that point. Now, if you make a mistake in that series of events and you end up creating another level 1 entry, I'll call this mistake display. You'll notice what you get is a different page. You got mistake display and page 1. Notice that it sandwiched mistake display between page 1 and your display that you wanted. So that really messed you up. So what you need to do at this point is go into outline mode, select view and outline, and at this point you can demote the mistake display to the level that you want, or you can move your displays around and reorder things. That's all done in outline mode. So when you go back to book mode, your displays are the way you want them. To delete a display, you simply select it and then click clear, and it will clear that display out. So that's how you create a display in a workbook. One of the nice features about ProcessBook is that it does give you shortcuts in various instances. In this case, if I want to add an element to an existing workbook, I simply make sure that I'm in build mode and I use the insert menu. From this point, you can click on display, text, or link OS command, and it will bring up the dialog box that you would have ordinarily arrived at from selecting new, file, new, and then ProcessBook entry. So it will save you a few steps using the insert menu from the menu bar. Now, there are other elements that we can create here, even though they are less often used, and those are found in the file, new, and ProcessBook entry menu. We can create additional text areas if we want at any level that we want to put a heading in, or we can click link and operating system command. And when you click link slash OS command, what you need to do is browse to the element that you want to put a link to. If you select a display file, it will create a display link. If you create another workbook, it'll create a link to that workbook. Or if you select operating system command, you select operating system command by pointing to a file, an application file that your system can understand. So for example, if I go to my browse button, and instead of clicking browse, I click on the little arrow that points down and display search, I can search for, under my computer, for all of the display files that might be on my computer. This may take a few moments, so be patient with it. And we can see here that I have a PDI file on my desktop that I can link to. I can call it Audible Alarm and click OK, and that will give me an Audible Alarm link to that PDI file in my workbook. I can title it there, click OK, and you notice that it does open up the file. So I've got my Audible Alarm link in there. You can link any operating system command, any executable, any other workbook. You can link them all into your display files or your workbooks.